In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the address function in Excel. We will cover the basics and advanced example using this particular function. Hey guys, welcome to Excel Tutorial channel. And in this video, we will use the address function in Excel to create a cell references as text based on a given row and column. If you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do it, because in the upcoming days, months, years, we're gonna cover so much about Excel and we are giving out so many informations for free. So if you will subscribe to this channel, it will add great value to us. So let's get started. So this is very basic data here. We have a sales value here, 2020, 19 to 2015 here, and we're gonna find the maximum sale here. And we will also use the helper function, which will be the address function, to find the address of it in this particular worksheet. So this will be our advanced example, but in the first part we will cover the basics of address function. So what is address function? Address function in Excel creates a cell reference as a text based on a given row and column number. So let's see the arguments of address function. So let me just put it right here. Let's see. So this have three mandatory, or I can say two mandatory argument of this function, which is the row number and column number. And we have three optional here, which is the first is abs number. Abs, what does the abs number mean? It means the address type. If you want it absolute, relative, etc. So it are defaults to absolute. So the A1 here is this the reference style. Like if you want a reference like R1 versus RCC1, like that, like row 1, column 1, or like A1. You can also do that. We will explore that also. So next is sheet. So it is the name of the worksheet to use, and it defaults to current worksheet you are working on. If you want to work with the external ones, you can also do that. So first row number and column number. To fill that these values, let's say if you have something like I want a row number 2 and row column number 3 here. So row number 2 will be like this and column number 3 will be like this. So let me just select this and intersect it with this. It should return the value as C2. Let's see if it does or not. Here the address function here. And now we have a row number. Row number is this and column number is this. So let's work with the mandatory argument and close it down here. So it gives us a C2 value. As you can see, C2 is absolute reference. So as a default, it return as a absolute references, as you can see as a dollar symbol here, right? And to explore more options here, let's see. So next option is the cell references. We want as an absolute row or relative column. Okay, let's see what it does. If we type 2 here, absolute row and relative column. So the relative will be the column, the C1. So it won't add that symbol and it won't lock that column, but the row will be like this. And if we see the next one here, relative row and absolute column here. So the column will be fixed with the C and the row will be relative like C2. But in generally, we want that as relative, because we want that as relative, because we don't want to fix anything else. And if you want to work with more functions after this, you can do that easily. If I do that, see, we got the C2 here without any absolute references. So what will be the next optional argument? So next will be the cell style, you know, cell reference style, you can say, which is R1 C1 style. What is R1 C1 style? R1 C1 style is row 1, column 1 style. So if we select this, you have to enter 0 here and click here. So you see, you get the R2, RC3 type. But you, as you can see, you get this brackets here. To eliminate those brackets, we need to just put it as an absolute here. And if we click that, you will delete those brackets here, because it will return as absolute references. You cannot alter this. So hope you get the point, the basics of address function in Excel. So it just returns the address of a particular cell on the basis of rows and columns. So now you may be wondering where you can apply this formula, right? where you can apply this function. It seems to be very useless function, but it is not. You can apply it on various calculation criterias. So we are going to perform that in next part. So now with the part second of this video will be the real life example, which is to apply address function in a real life example. So how you gonna do that? So we have a maximum sale column here, and we have this years 2022 down to 2015. So now we have this sales value here, and in the sales value we need to find the maximum sale value which we have incurred in these particular years. So how we gonna do that? To do that, we need to select this. To do that, first basically we need to find the maximum value in this particular column, right? So I will say max. Now number one, number two, it says we just apply the column here and note it down and see. So maximum value says 2020, we don't need that, right? Because 2020 is our year number. So to correct that, we will select particular range, right? And if we close it down, so you can see we got the 990 number. The maximum sales value will be the 990 number. But the thing is, if you have, I have this like 24 values here, but if you have a values like in thousands, and you cannot find this value in that particular ranges because it has a thousands of value and you cannot locate it like one by one going to, or you can do that obviously with the control plus F or control plus one. But if you want to direct your reader, because your worksheet should be readable to whomever you want to send, right? And to do that, you need a address to match that. So to first we need to use the match function here. Why? Let me tell you why. Here it says the lookup value, and it also says lookup array. For the array part, I will select this column here, right? And it also says the less than match, it's optional match type, so it will be our exact match here. And let me just close it down here. Let's see what it says. It says the seventh value is our answer. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So it's our seventh value here in the range we have selected. So you must be wondering why we are not counting from the 325, because our lookup value is this, which is 990, as you can see, because the max function returns only the maximum value here. So for the maximum value, we have chosen this particular range, which is the 82 to 824. But in the match section, we have the lookup array, which column, which is the whole A column. So it has to count from the first value, which is the 220. Hope you understand that. So it says seventh here. And now to find this particular cell number, you know, we got this here like seven, but you may have get this like thousands in thousands value. To find the exact address, we need the address function to find the exact cell number, right? So to address, so we have this address function here, and in the row column and column, it has all been taken care of. Now when to select the row column number, which is the first, let me just put it like first here, or you can also select as a AA. So for the column number A, and then it's up to you if you want to choose these particular options here. So I'm just doing a default here. Now if I select this, so it says the A7. So A7, here we got the reference to our maximum sale number. So the thing is, if you apply like this to all, it will give the same answer. Why? Because it will only extend the A3 part to A25 part. It won't extend to the column, to the next column part. So you have to edit all these formulas here. Let me just edit here to B2 here, 24. And for the column part, we need to select B, and there you go. It says A20, which is 967, which is the highest value. And for the rest of the part, I will let you to do that. You can find the Excel file to be linked in the following description box, so you can get from there and fill these values for me, and you can also work around these values. So hope you get the point. If you have got the point, please click the like button. If you have some questions in mind, you have comment box with you. And if you want to subscribe to our channel to get more Excel tips, tricks like this, you can also subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video. Until then, bye bye.